Hello everybody and welcome. I am Man vs. Pixels and today I'm going to be asking the question, is Gears of War still any good? As it approaches its 15th anniversary, I'm going to see how it holds up compared to modern shooters. I haven't played it since it came out in 2006, so let's jump in and find out. The version of Gears of War I've played through is the Gears of War Ultimate Edition, which has got a few graphics enhancements compared to the original, but it's not the graphics I'm going to be looking at. I want to get into the game itself, its style, its design, its mechanics, the overall feel, see how that holds up. Does it appear dated or old-fashioned compared to the shooters of 2021? Some of the first things that jumped out at me as I played. Now, I always remembered Gears as a very macho game, its characters, its dialogue. This is still the case. Obviously, they haven't changed that, but it seems a bit cliche now. There's only one female character in the whole game, Anya, and we only see her briefly in a cutscene. The rest of the time, she's just a voice in Marcus Fenix's ear. Every other character is built like the Hulk and talks like Dirty Harry. Now, nothing wrong with that in my book, but most modern games have moved away from this hyper-macho style. It was a criticism at the time, I remember, and future games added female characters in larger roles. Anya became a part of Delta in Gears 3, and the main playable character in Gears 5 is a female character. But this all-male, testosterone-infused style reminds me very much of 90s pro wrestling. So that was one of the things I noticed that kind of dated the game. The next thing that immediately stood out to me was the drab colour palette. This was another criticism of the game at the time, but this grey and brown colour scheme, all the environments are basically concrete or mud, and very little to bright and things up. By contrast, sort of modern shooters, even military ones that have lots of camo and grass and things in them, they do their best to make environments a bit more vibrant, with more vibrant skyboxes, various different interiors, levels set in different climates, snow, desert, that kind of thing, just to change up the colour palette. But Gears has got a very dull aesthetic, and I feel like it dates it to a period where military shooters just didn't do colour. The co-op squad mechanics are something a bit anachronistic as well. A Gears could be played in two-player co-op mode, and that was a big deal at the time, and quite a selling point, and very good fun to play through with a friend in that mode. But the way it was implemented in games seems a little bit dated now. There's a lot of scripted sections where you, as Fenix, and another character, usually Dom, have to split up and take different routes, high ground or low ground, or just two different routes for a building or something. It's not very fluid or dynamic, like the co-op play of current offerings. It seems a bit more forced. It's kind of an early iteration of what co-op shooters would become. One of the biggest things that became obvious to me as I played through the campaign was just how slow the game felt compared to modern shooters. Not so much the pace of the story, which runs along pretty well, with minimal interruptions, not that many cutscenes, and they ain't too long, but the gameplay itself does a lot of things to keep the pace down. The movement, you move slowly, very slowly. Even the iconic roadie run was clearly designed just to move you between bits of cover, not to generally traverse the map with any sort of speed. You get a strange perspective shift and a weird control difference when you're in the roadie run that just makes it unusable really for moving through the map. Add to that the very strange phenomenon of having to walk at half speed by holding two fingers to your ear whenever you're talking on the radio, which happens quite a lot. You find yourself plodding along at a pace that seems unnaturally laborious. The cover-based combat was a signature of Gears at the time, and that snap to or sticky cover system was used by many other games around the period. It's a system that seems to have fallen right out of favour at the moment in modern shooters, another mechanic that slows the game down. A few other things in combat that keep the pace a little slow, just little things like having to press a key to pick up ammo instead of just walking over it. There's ammo boxes all over the place, but you can't just walk over them to pick up ammo for a gun you've already got. You have to actually press a key and there's an animation to bend down and pick it up. Also, the need to swap to and equip the grenades before you can throw them. Like most modern shooters now will just have a quick key press to throw a grenade. Having to actually equip the grenade and throw it just takes that bit of extra time and sort of keeps the pace of the combat slow. The general length of things like reload, weapon swap, and pickup animations all seem a bit longer, just, you know, a few frames longer than faster, more modern shooters. There's also a lot of use of like triggered events that are required to progress through a level, like maybe a door that you can't get through being broken open by an enemy barging in that then gives you the route to progress through the level. Sometimes this led me to a bit of confusion of not being able to work out where to go in a part of the level because I hadn't just stood on the right spot to trigger that event. It seemed to me like that way of progressing through a level seems quite outdated now, even for linear shooters of today. There's also a lot of kicking down doors that just seems unnecessary. Like when you get to a door, you have to press a key to kick it down. Why have the door there at all? Why not just go through it? Just something that slows the pace of the game. So those are the main things I noticed that stood out to me as being a bit old hat or outright obsolete in the game design, the way it plays out. Despite all that, I still enjoyed playing through the game again after all these years, but I'd hesitate to recommend it to a younger gamer that didn't play it back in the day, a gamer that's more used to the faster, twitchier, smoother games of like Apex or Fortnite or any of the modern Call of Duties. If I did recommend it to someone who hadn't played it, it would be with the caveats of how some of the dated mechanics and design might be a touch jarring. So to answer the question I asked at the beginning, is it still any good? I think it's still a solid and fun shooter, but it shows its age. It doesn't hold up that well to the design and gameplay of modern offerings. Tell me what you think about that in the comments. Like and dislike as you feel you need to, and I'll talk to you again soon.